Welcome back to Ultimate Skyrim, my friends. This is Season 1, Episode 75. We are exactly where we left off, at this abandoned wolf den, and we are on our way back to Whiterun, hopefully to find the conclusion to this Alakir quest that we've been on. I'm here with Lydia on this beautiful Whiterun morning. It's looking like we need to eat some breakfast for the day. Maybe drink up a little bit. Let's see. What do you got, Lydia? You got some beverages, too? Or are you going to get mad because you don't have any? That's right. She still doesn't have a water skin. I remember that being a problem in the last one. I hope you guys are having a good day today. I know I am. It's a nice Saturday today. In fact, I'm actually recording this on the day that it goes up. Work on the manual is going swimmingly. I'm actually super, super excited to show you guys what I've been working on. What did you just say, Lydia? You're proud of what we'd accomplished? That's so weirdly relevant to what I was just saying. My lantern's on, so I gotta go ahead and turn that off. And let's go ahead and see. Well, that's supposed to be, there we go. This is my magic menu. It's not actually what I meant to open out. What I started to say is that I'm thinking what I'm going to do with the manual, because right now, like I said in the last episode, is that I'm working on this large mod list, which is kind of the primary feature of this manual. So I'm thinking that I might just host that once it's complete, even if the stuff in the beginning and end is not yet complete. I'll work on that in the meantime. At least that way, like, this big mod list serves as a pretty important resource in and of itself, so I can give you guys, like, early access to that kind of thing. Figure that would be kind of fun, right? So this is Lydia. She has practically nothing. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take her red apple. That way she's guaranteed to eat the apple cabbages too. I'm going to eat this myself, and then I'll worry about the rest of the stuff later. Man, I must be carrying a lot of food. And also a lot of potions. I think that's weighing me down. But it's okay, because we have a lot of carry weight. And we also have horses. Anyway, let's go ahead and pop this. Yeah, that's not going to do it for my hunger. Not anywhere close. But at least Lydia will eat hers. And then I can go ahead and pop a cooked meat. Why are these interfaces lagging it today? That's a weird thing. Give me a horker loaf, mildly stale. I should have eaten the venison stew, because it's a little bit stale too. That's all right. All right, I'm sorry, Lydia. You want some more food? Here, you can have some apples and what's it called? I think I have some cooked beef, some cabbage soup. That ought to do it, right? There's an apple for you. That's a full day's meal right there. Not really, not if you're a adventuring fighter who's constantly burning calories by running around. Look at that giant over there. Man, those things really are huge. All right, let's go ahead and call both of our horses over yonder. Queen Alfsigur and Ysmira. We can go ahead and run it on foot. I don't mind so much being on foot when it's daylight. But at nighttime, I don't like venturing out at all at nighttime in general. It's just a real bad idea. It's a good way to get yourself killed through some stupid nonsense. It's easy to forget because, like I've said in many episodes, we made it through so much stuff that we probably should have been killed by anyway. But, like, very often, like, we are inches away from death, I would imagine. Like, there are plenty of things that can still kill Hjolfrid outright, like just straight up killer without very much trouble at all. Mages can do it, especially frost mages. Vampires probably, and all of their cloak spells, and those things are super terrible to deal with. Vampires and cloak spells. What else? Giants, that's another thing that can send us into orbit pretty easily. Where is Lydia? Whatever, I don't even care. It's the Whiterun Plains, we should be okay. Really the worst thing I think we're gonna encounter here would be like a saber cat, which is not that hard to deal with in the grand scheme of things. Ooh, have we done this yet, this puzzle over here? It's really easy to do. We might as well do it. I think there's a chest that we get out of it that could have some pretty dank loot. So since we're here, might be nice just to kind of do it anyway. Also, we can say hello to the person who runs this farm, I suppose. We won't be able to interact with them, even if we could have through, like, what's it called? Immersive merchandising? Is that a dog? Or a cow? I think it's a dog. Yeah, it's definitely a dog. Alright, so let's go ahead and do this real fast. Let's see what we got. Oh, I'm pretty slow, too. Where's my... There we go. I must be... Oh, look at this weird animation sliding. There we go. I think that's better now, right? Yeah, there we go. So I'm moving pretty slow, I think, because I have so much stuff on me. Like, let me see if I can go ahead and offload a bunch of this junk. What else do I have that's taken up so much space? Probably the food. Or let's just go ahead and sort by all. Weight. The greatsword, that's one. I can go ahead and put that away, at least for now, I think. Why do I have an imperial saddle on me? The staff of frostbite, wooden staff of lightning bolts. Whoa, wait a second. That's pretty garbage value compared to this one. 40 points, 10 points per second, draining both health and stamina. Spells released, the cold slowly ebbs away. Casting multiple ice winds at the same target will not increase it. Yeah, it's not even that great. I'll go ahead and dump both of those just for solidarity's sake. Novice robes or restoration, we want to keep that. There's some food. This is all stuff that we need. Man, we're just all up on stuff that we actually need. Really, a scroll weighs 0.5 pounds? That doesn't seem correct, but whatever. I'm fine with it. It's all these potions that are weighing us down, but I just can't bring myself to get rid of them because, like, they really are useful. It's a problem. Ooh, Scroll of Conjure Shelter. That's okay. We really have a lot of stuff here. I've not really looked through this, but this might be a good chance for us to kind of, like, go and, what's it called? Do some dungeons that perhaps might be beyond our skill level. Oh, well, I mean, that's kind of what our plan was anyway. So we'll go ahead and do that for fun. Do some Draugr dungeons after we go to... we actually have a lot of really fun stuff lined up. We get to go to the Throat of the World, and we... Oh, gosh. What is happening? Oh, my God. No wonder I'm moving so slow. I was fucking crouched. That makes a lot more sense. That giant scared the shit out of me, though. But yeah, we have a lot of really fun stuff lined up. All right, so let's go ahead and do this real fast. Let's see what we got. And that needs to be a whale... And then this guy should be a... Let's see if it doesn't show. It's like in the rubble. There it is. It's a eagle. So I think it's supposed to face away from it. Or maybe towards the center thing. This thing. Let's go ahead and... Well, I don't know. What looks like it makes the most sense? Maybe like that? We'll see in a second. And what about you? How about you, my friend? This one's also broken. It's a snake. So let's go ahead and put it out... This way? Right? That makes sense to me. Gonna do it? Did it do it? No? It's gotta be the snake that's wrong. Or the eagle, rather. So maybe this way? This one was the eagle, right? I'm not crazy? Okay. There we are. That did it. You guys just go ahead and chill out there for a quick second. What do we got? Ooh, there's a book down here. Mage coat, huh? That sounds like an alteration spell. That is not the right... menu to go to. Let's go ahead and check it out. Mage coat, alteration, yes, improves the caster's warmth rating by 10 by for 150. That's pretty good, but we don't really have much in the way of alteration. So, I mean, okay, it's fine. Well, hypothetical treachery, a one-act play by Anthil Morvir. Huh, interesting. Garnet, soul gem lesser. Hey, it's filled with a soul, that's pretty good. Not a, I mean, amazing haul, but also not terrible. Definitely worth the stop, I think. All right, well, let's go ahead and check out this farm just for fun. Might be able to get some milk from these cows and give that to Lydia because she doesn't have a water skin right now, so it might be nice. Got some gourds. The Barley Dark Farm, huh? Anyone here? Oh, hello. Hey, guy. You know, it's kind of dangerous being all the way out here on your lonesome, although it does look like he has some giants that he's friendly with.
Come to gawk at the dark elf?
No, I was just saying hello. You don't have to project your insecurities or anything onto me. It's like, I'm sorry, I'll leave you alone if it's so much of a problem. Hey, guys. I'm going to go ahead and grab some milk. Thank you. And how about another one, just in case? Nice. All right, Lydia, here, you can have these. Milk for strong bones. It's always good to have. I actually love milk. A jug of milk. There you go. All right, sweet. I guess we'll just keep on going. Look, the Throat of the World. The Greybeards, what's it called? Hi, Hrothgar, that's what I'm looking for. All right, ladies. Oh, it's so loud in my ears. Come on over. Oh, I think I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, give me a second. So, if you guys remember, I'm still kind of torn morally about this whole Saadia Alakir situation. What I would like to do, ideally, I don't know if there will be an option to do this. Hey, Lydia, where are you going? Hey, honey. Whoa, this is weird. We're, like, attached at the hip here. There we go. Hey, Lydia. Where are you going? She should just teleport onto the horse, I think. Where are you going, crazy? Whoa. Hey, guy. What's up? Oh, there she goes. Every time they get on the horse, though, I really gotta find a way to get horsing around working, because I'm so tired of having to put my weapon away. Just chilling out. Oh, hey, look at this. Is that giant? Oh, no, he's huge as well. He was just farther away. Thought we might have had a smaller giant on our hands. It's pretty smart. I bet you this guy... In fact, I've seen this farm like interact with the giants by offering some cows as tribute, which would be pretty smart. I wouldn't be surprised at all if that character has kind of a resting agreement with the giants. Maybe, you know, because he's out here. He's in the middle of the plains. It's a pretty dangerous area. Not really well patrolled because of, you know, Skyrim's problems. So it would be smart to kind of get in good with the giants because they could help you protect your farm and protect your livestock. Like, we've seen what they can do firsthand. What do we got here? Uh-oh. Is he aiming? You are aiming at me. Are you guys... That's like... What are you doing, bro? And who are you? Are they all fighting me? What is happening here? I'll take you out. Boom. That's right, it did. Who was that? Maybe that was a thief and he was about to accost these guys. And then I guess maybe saw me as more of a threat? Let's go ahead and pop off. Let's see what that person's deal was. It looks like they're wearing vampire armor. No, just a wood elf, huh? What's your problem, bro? Arrow iron Bosmer cuirass, huh? Pretty cool looking. Crimson archer boots, firewood, hide bracers, leather strips. Nothing all that fantastic. These are always good to have, I suppose. Silver garnet ring. That's what. Hey, and a water skin. Perfect. Hey, Lydia, look what I got for you. Oh, I was like, hey, look, she gets the quick dismount as well. That's super cool. I didn't even know they could do that. Here you go. Wait, I'm gonna sneeze. Did I say I was gonna sneeze before and then I didn't? I'm sorry, that's so misleading. There you go. Now you don't even have to drink milk. Maybe you're lactose intolerant. I really don't know. Oh, the other thing I'm gonna do while we're here is go ahead and read a hypothetical treachery. One act play. Should we thumb through it real fast? I don't want to. I'm in an action mood today. I want to get stuff done progress-wise, quest-wise. I'm gonna circumvent this fort, I think, right now. Ugh. Reset my camera again. With horsing around, it works perfectly as like an offset to that. It's just finicky. It's weird. I just can't get it to work properly, it seems. Alright, let's go ahead and jump in. I'm also having some interesting issues here, it seems, with the draw distance of plants. That's strange to me. Like these cells. Yeah, see, like, they're all that foliage just popped in. I've never seen that happen before, but it seems to be affecting me today. I don't know. Whatevs, yo. I'm not worried about it. It's, I mean, I'm always, like, I try to be kind. Yeah, look at this. Same thing. These cells are loading in super slow. I have to assume that it's just because I'm taxing my machine so heavily by recording. It's like when you have a mod list that's 300 mods deep, it's like recording episodes is quite taxing. Also, oh, you know what's also worth considering, too, is that Hjolfrid's save, we are, like, we kind of pulled her save from the dredges, or from the depths, from the old version of Ultimate Skyrim, so I guess it's just, because I noticed that wasn't happening on Armand, so maybe it's something Hjolfrid specific. Hey, guys, what you doing?
Doing fairs and weapons. There's been a profitable for sale at fair price. And yet I long for the warm sands of elsewhere.
Yes, yes, yes.
Kajita's wares, if you have coin.
All right, Rasad, I'm always down to look and see what you got. Amulet of Life Force plus 10. That's not even that good. Amulet of Shielding, lesser. Activate a lesser shield. That's pretty cool. I love these amulets and jewelry that give you powers that you can use, like spells. It's kind of fun because like being a mage is cool and like spells are cool. But you never really get to, you know, dabble in that when you are a heavy armor character. See, backpacks, bear pelts, tunics. We got dolls, we got alchemy, ooh, paralysis. Wow, this has probably multiple paralysis recipes. Ingots, Well, you know what? Maybe it would be worth selling. I'm probably going to wait until we talk to Bellathor, actually, to sell some stuff because we'll get better prices from inside the city. All these poisons. Potion of Cloak of Frost. Cloak of Frost, 30 seconds, opponents in melee range take 8 points frost damage and stamina damage. That's pretty cool. You can imagine that being pretty cool as like a mage. Man, there's just so many possibilities that all of these different... look! Oh my god, they even have Wormstone from Wormstooth on the caravans. That's so cool. I had no idea. In fact, that's probably an edit that I made in order to reconcile those two, because you have to merge the leveled lists. It's really not that hard to do. I'm thinking about making some videos on doing some advanced modding stuff like that in the future. Steel Gauntlets of Sure Grip. Damn it. Ooh, fuck. That's pretty cool. Ooh, I think I want that. How much gold do I have? I'm buying that. There we go. See, that's why you always check. You always check to see if they have cool stuff. And this book right here, this is really good to have if you are doing like a merchant playthrough or if you're just interested in that kind of stuff. Thank you, Rasad. Here. I'm sure it's not as good as, what is it, my Hedge Knight Gauntlets? Right, yeah, they have better armor. What about the steel ones? steel gauntlets of sure grip. I mean, it's actually a significant amount more armor, those hedge knight gauntlets, but the steel grip is, I think, worth it. That's a pretty dope enchantment. TBH, let's go ahead and see. Spellbinder, steel gauntlets of sure grip. So we got to add that, there we go, to the, and hey, maybe that'll get rid of our equip set problem. Let's see. All right, so we're here. This one seems to work fine. That equips, everything equips properly. It's just this first equip set that seems to have trouble. All right, let's see. I think it did it. Let's see. Hey, there we go. That solved the problem. Something weird about those gauntlets, or like maybe the Hedge Knight set. I'm not super sure. Beautiful day in Whiterun. So here's what I would like to do. I started to say this. Kind of the moral ambiguity of this Saadia situation is kind of a problem. I don't know. It's just, it's so not clear who's telling the truth. I wish that either party in this dispute could offer me some sort of evidence that what they're saying is what's actually happening. But, you know, sometimes things don't shake out that way. In an ideal situation, I would have an option to tell Saadia what I had learned or what I had heard from Kamatu and just kind of gauge her reaction. But because this is Skyrim, I wouldn't be surprised at all if the only option that I have is to go send her to what might be her death, what might be a trial, and then eventually her death. Probably not a good situation for her to be in the hands of those Alakir. For her, anyway. So we'll just have to wait and see, I suppose. We'll go talk to her, see what options we have available, and then we'll make a decision based on that. Now, what do you guys have over here? A beautiful day in Whiterun, to be sure. Breeze home. You know, it might be worth looking into getting a home soon. Although, really, it's like we're so adventurer style in this character that I don't know, maybe it wouldn't be worth it, because that money can obviously go to other things, like, you know, the more money we spend on housing and stuff, the more, although we could always rent out our house. That's something worth considering. We don't only have to do property investment on Armand.
Bellathor's general goods.
So many options.
Indeed.
Welcome to you. Now that's a weird thing. Oh, welcome to you, Bellathor. Welcome to your own store.
Take a look.
You guys ever do that when you're in conversation with this? Oh my God, it happens to me like on my birthday. People will be like, happy birthday. And you're like, happy birthday to you too. And you're like, oh, I'm an awkward person. Okay, let's go ahead and sell off what I have here. And then I'll go and sell stuff from the horse's inventory. Don't need that. Need the common shoes. Don't need the gauntlets. Yada, yada, yada. Need all these. Don't need this. Don't need that. Oh shit. I didn't get a, what's it called? I didn't talk to a beggar to get my bonus. Oh, well, whatever. We're already here, and I don't feel like going and doing it again. Wow, we already made up a fair amount of gold. Is there some of this stuff that we can sell that we don't need? Arcane Disruption? I don't know. This is, I get what, I think, Ben Yahtzee Croshaw, the zero punctuation guy, I think he coined this term. I really love using it. Bigger Crab Syndrome. Where you see this a lot in shooters like Half-Life, where you have so many different types of weapons and, you know, a bunch of, like, ammo, all these different ammo reserves. Same problem in Skyrim, where, like, it's like you have all this stuff that you could use, but you don't want to use it because you're afraid that you might need it. Like, you don't want to use it on this crab because there might be a bigger crab, like, around the corner, if that makes sense. And you just end up inundated with, like, all this stuff that you just, like, don't want to ever waste. It's tricky. Let's see. I want lantern oil. That's what I'm looking for. I don't need that much, but I'll take 3. That's fine. All right, sweet.
Do come back.
Will do, Bellathor. Man, don't sound so sarcastic. Oh, wait, actually, here. Queen Alfsigar, give me your inventory. And we need that stuff. Staff of Frostbite. I'm going to go ahead and sell this Staff of Frostbite because I just don't give a shit about it. I'm going to sell the Imperial Saddle. And la 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 la. I'm going to hold on to those. Linen wrap, roll of paper. I want to keep everything here. That's all fine and dandy. Okay. What about last? Oops, sorry, Lydia. Oops, that's not what I meant to do either. I meant to hit this button. There we go. And then check use mirrors inventory just in case. I don't think she has anything for me to sell. No, she does not. Get rid of this real fast. Shush your mouth.
This and a bit of that.
Yada yada yada. What did I just pick up? The staff. Staff of Frostbite. Get out of here. Not even that good. And I can sell a hypothetical treachery now. I don't need that anymore. Right? And the spell tote, that's a pretty good price, right? 428? Sure, why not? Boom. There we are. Got some gold.
Remember, I'll give you the best deals or die trying.
I don't believe you'd die trying, Bellathor. I'm just being perfectly honest. But hey, I appreciate the showmanship. Bellathor is pretty cool. I mean, I guess he's kind of the first big city merchant that most players encounter since you come to Whiterun so early in the vanilla game. He's interesting. The fire keeps me from getting any colder. Is that so, Hjalfrid? Right, let's go talk to Saadia. Let's see what sort of options she gives us. We'll just have to play it by ear. Am I right or am I right?
Come on in. We got warm food.
You come on in!
And warm beds.
Yeah. Thanks, Hulda. I actually do appreciate your hospitality. You're my girl. All right, Lydia, let's go talk to Saadia. Lydia, Saadia, so many names ending in ah.
Any news of the Alakir?
Ah, seriously? That's the only option that I have. All right, guys, this is our game time decision. Well, so they want her alive, which is an interesting thing, which makes me think that they're going to have her stand trial. Or maybe they want to interrogate her. Maybe the Thalmor would want to interrogate her, and that's why they want her alive. I feel so bad just lying outright to her face. The alternative is just killing all those dudes, which, like, seems a little bit... I don't know, here's, like, an interesting egalitarian decision. It's like, no matter what, like, it's a choice between one person potentially dying and, like, 7 or 8 people definitely dying. Those people have dubious innocence, whereas hers is more in a question, but we don't know that they've done anything wrong. Fuck it. Sorry, Saadia.
What? How? I thought they weren't allowed within the city.
They found a way in. We need to get you out of here. All right, here
we
go.
Where do I go? I can't keep running forever.
There's a horse waiting at the stables. I'll make sure you're safe. I don't feel good about this.
I have to pick up and leave again? If you really think this is the only way, I trust you. Let's not waste any time. See you around.
I don't know how I feel about this, guys. What other option is there? There should be another option. There should be, like, a third option that says, this is what I would like. This is my ideal scenario. I would like an option that says, hey, I went and talked to Kamatu. They told me some stuff that was really counter to what you told me. I don't know who to believe here. They told me to come and, you know, tell you to trick you, and I just don't know who to believe, and I want to wipe my hands of the whole situation. So if you want to stay alive, you should probably run, or, you know, like, take your chances staying here. I don't care. It's not my problem anymore. That's what I would like to do. Oh, God. I suppose we don't have to lead her to her death right here. Like, what happens, I wonder, if we, like, attack... Oh, she's just going. Okay, well, so I guess it's happening either way. Let's see how this unfolds, my friends. There she goes. All right, Lydia, I know you'll stick with me no matter what. Oh, my God. This is like, I was talking with a couple of you guys in the comments about Hjalfrid's, like, political inclinations and how I think, historically speaking, she's been non-participatory in kind of, like, politics. We don't exactly know what her history was before she came to Skyrim, but what I think is that she's a very smart person. I think that she pays attention, and, you know, it's like the war against the Thalmor and what was essentially their bloody crusade against non-high-elf races. That was still pretty recent, and as long as Hjalfrid was a citizen of the world during that time, it would be hard not to notice, you know, that Thalmor's activities and have some opinion on it one way or another. I think Hjalfrid is pretty anti-establishment, and you know, this is what makes it difficult, because like Kamatu, they're kind of an establishment. I was talking about this with Adrian. They're pretty establishment, but I mean, there's no bigger establishment right now than the Thalmor, so to speak. So if we're doing this to work against the Thalmor, but even then, it's not really something that works against the Thalmor. It's just potentially bringing this person in for, like, a maybe modicum of justice. So, I don't know. This shit's fucked up, man. Let's see what happens. I don't know. Let's see. Oh, boy.
Doing something like that with dragons on the loose and a war going on?
Yeah, were you talking about the Khajiit? Or is it...
Let's go. Can't believe it's come to this.
Me either, Saadia. I really, really can't. I mean, I guess it's kind of my fault. Who dat? Are you guys Vigilance? You're coming right at me.
We meet at last. See you later.
What is this? What have you done?
Oh, come now.
You didn't really expect to manipulate people forever, did you? Your luck had to run out sometime.
Whoa! Oh, he missed. Wait a second, what the hell? I think he was supposed to paralyze her right there. And he didn't. Uh-oh. What happens now? What the hell?
Let's get to the stables before they find me.
Yeah, that's where we are, Saadia.
Now we'll take our friend here back to hell.
Okay.
Where she will pay the price for her treason.
She won't be harmed? Back.
Once she gets there, it's not up to me to decide what's done with her. And as for you, I owe you a portion of the reward, don't I? Well, here you go. Spend it wisely, and if I may, don't allow yourself to be fooled by a pretty face.
Okay, Lydia. Am I, really? Oh, shit! Whoa! Oh. Whoa! Whoa! Yay! Okay, well, I don't think that's how this was supposed to go down. You know what I'm gonna do right now? Okay, that was really, really wonky and strange. Well, thank you so much, Skyrim. Let's run through that one more time, and then see if the same thing happens, because, I mean, that could just be Skyrim weird wonkiness. But, like, maybe that quest is, like, broken somehow? I don't know. You guys go ahead and stay right there. Well, how about this? I'll pause the video right here, and then we'll just jump straight to the part where he's confronting her and see what happens. Okay, so I just went here and ran through the sequence again. He tried to hit her with a paralyzed spell, and it didn't work again. So clearly something is not as it's intended to be here. I think I'm just going to let this play out. And, like, this is going to take some, what's it called? Some leniency on your guys' part. So I'm going to talk to Kamatu. He'll run through the sequence. It seems like Saadia apparently is going to aggro me, and she's going to have to die. But we'll just kind of pretend as though she didn't and that the quest played out as it should. And I'm going to revisit this quest in the mod files and just see what the heck's going on there. Maybe just give it a cursory Google search to see if this has happened to anyone else. Or maybe you guys will have, like, an example of it happening to you. So we'll see.
We'll take our friend here back to Hammerfell, where she will pay the price for her treason.
All right.
On the way back. Once she gets there, it's not up to me to
see. His dialogue seems so genuine, like this is actually what's gonna happen.
I owe you a portion of the reward.
But I just don't know.
Here you go. Spend it wisely, and if I may, don't allow yourself to be fooled by a pretty face. You're better than that.
Oh yeah?
Oh no.
I don't think so. I don't think so. Whoa. Oh, I missed. Get back here. Oh, wait, maybe we can just, I don't know. This is kind of like interesting. How about this? How about this? Wait, Lydia. Lydia, how about this? I have an idea, an interesting idea. Now, I still have to go ahead and make sure that this, quest is not broken. However, this might make a interesting solution to our problem.
You can't win this.
What if she runs off? Then this is kind of the equivalent. You gotta run, lady. Go. Oh. Okay, you gotta get out of here then. Go, run. I'm letting you run. Don't do this. I'm gonna give you 10 seconds. I'm gonna give you 5 seconds. All right, I'm gonna give you 0 seconds. Ow. Ugh. Oh, there we are. Yeah, sure. Sorry about that, Lydia. Well, okay, we can roleplay that however we want. We can roleplay that maybe her actual, or that spell failed and she just attacked us and we had to put her down anyway. In fact, that's actually how I want to do it, because we have a corpse sitting in front of us right now. Let's go ahead and call that what happened. Sorry, Saadia. Sorry it didn't end up, better for you. Man, what an interesting little glitch. That's kind of a problem. But I'll definitely figure out, like, how to do it. Oh, and look here. And you know what is also worth considering is it could just be... Keep in mind, Hjolfrid's playthrough is going to be super weird because of all that stuff. I keep forgetting that. All that stuff that I said before. See, like, there's her inventory, Holmgira, whoever you are. Maybe... Because I'll try it on a different save that's not all donked and see if the same nonsense still happens, because Hjolfrid's save is all weird and finicky. So I'll go ahead and verify everything's working properly after this, so you guys don't have to worry about it. Anyway, come here, horses. Now we are, I think probably, let's see. We can take this carriage, or should we ride through? I kind of want to ride through to, what's it called? To Iverstead, because it's fun. It's a really nice jaunt. So how about we go along the White River, and that'll take us through, what's it called? Valheim Towers. That's always a cool little area. You never know what you'll find over that way. I bet you we haven't taken down Valheim Towers as this character, have we? I bet you we could. I think it would be even more fun to do if we were, what's it called? If we had unrelenting force, because then we can knock people off the bridge. Sorry, I want to go to Lydia here. And not equipment, I want to go to command, and then I want to take her aggression and put it back to aggressive. There you go. Let's go ahead and jump on. Oh, this is, oh, no wonder, I got on the wrong horse. Ugh, how annoying. I'm going to throw a couple minutes onto this. Just so, because we've done a lot of nonsense in this episode. Only me, my team. There you go. There you go. There you go. Sorry. You guys are wearing the same armor. It's easy to confuse you. All right, Lydia, let's do it. Let's ride. There she goes. I begin to warm up, huh? And pull this out. Hey, farmers. What are you guys doing? Oh, there's an elk. Those elk, you know, those are all tagged to avoid roads, all those kind of like skittish wildlife. I don't think they do a fantastic job of that with the default Skyrim AI or whatever AI packages. I don't know if Skytest edits any of those AI packages, but it seems a little, they're supposed to be avoiding roads. They don't seem all that great at it. This is my point. Yeah, I'm definitely going to go ahead and see about that quest. That was so strange. I've never seen that, because I've done that Alakir quest like many times before. I've never seen her not get paralyzed. Let's ride out. This is not a particularly pretty day. It was so much prettier in the morning. I thought it was going to be a nice clear day, but instead we get this nasty overcast nonsense. I actually have overcast nonsense in real life, too, right now. I can see out my window, and it's kind of gray today. Is that a wolf? You gonna attack me? Looks like he might. I would suggest against it. Whoa! How did I even... Man, the hitboxes when you're on horseback are so generous, to say the least. Where's Lydia? Hey, Lids. Here she comes. I see you. I seen you, girl. Look up there. That's where we're going. If only we could just climb right up. I actually think it would be possible, given the super weird, finicky horse physics in Skyrim. Also, what's over here? This is that bandit place? Oh, is there actually a path up through here? Holy crap! There is! I had no idea! Okay, well, we're going this way. I've never done this before. Interesting. Maybe, hey, maybe we'll encounter like a Nordic ruin along the way. That'd be fun, right? That's kind of what we're gearing towards. There's a fox. We got like a little... Oh, it's a Stormcloak camp! Interesting. Well, they're friendly to me, right? Right? Yep, I think so. Wow, it's interesting to note that this is here. I didn't know. I mean, I'm sure I've encountered it at some point during my playthroughs, but when you've been playing this game for so long and when I spend so much time modding versus actually playing, it's easy to forget stuff like that. All right, so let's go ahead and double back. Looks like this path branches off over this way, right? Yeah, right up through here. Is this what it's pointing to? Am I on it? Maybe, maybe not. Am I crazy? Am I going the wrong way? Let's check the map. No, I went the wrong way. Okay, so the path, here's the path, and the path continues on. Here we go. This has got to be it, right? Am I crazy? Is this it? Yeah, well, okay, now we're on it. Awesome. So let's go ahead and give it a couple minutes of riding through this path. Ooh, we got some dense foliage to watch out for here. That's always a problem. Oh, I had no idea this was here. I guess that's why it pays to have a map with roads, you know what I'm saying? Let's keep it going. I'm watching out for frost wraiths, ice wraiths in particular, and trolls. Huh, interesting. I wonder if we'll find any sort of dungeons and stuff along the way. Oh, this is so cool. Look at this view of Whiterun we have. In fact, I think this will be the part to stop the video. Huh. Let's go ahead and see what we got. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. So something to note before I go. I told you guys that I'm not running the actual Dindu LOD, Dindu LOD ESP right now because of some problems I've been having with it. But if you run the Dindu LOD process, it still generates all of like the distant objects and stuff, which is what you can see here. You just won't get the like the actual distant waterfalls or like spinning mills or whatever, which is not that big of a deal. Wow, is it already late? 12:35 p.m. No, it's not. It's just kind of like a delicate looking sky today. Beautiful. Anyway, I go ahead and I say we'll call that episode. I'll go fix that problem with, what's it called? With Saadia, or at the very least, just test it out, see if it works. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. So as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you later.